trust is seriously being questioned on the Traitors. But on Monday night, Chloe, who is a clairvoyant, threw a spanner in the works when she shared her predictions in the banishment room. Watch this.
Okay, Chloe, your vote, please.
Okay, so, Kashandi, Muriel, Angus, and Teresa are the traitors. I would like to leave the room, please.
Chloe, do you need to leave now, or are you comfortable?
No, I would like to leave. Good luck.
Are you leaving the game or the room?
Oh, my God.
Oh. I've never been more terrified if the clairvoyant left the room. I was like, I'm not going with you. I don't care where we're going. Last night, we learned that Chloe decided to exit the show, but she's joining us now. Chloe, it's great to have you here.
Hi, welcome.
Last night, you guessed that there was four traitors, but you also correctly guessed Angus and Mariel. How did you do that?
Yeah, so I actually knew those two people were traitors before going into the show. I know. I knew that there was going to be a long brown-haired male and then a long brown-haired female. So when I saw them straight away, I was like, it's you two.
How did you know?
Things up my sleeve.
How did you know?
Well, I spoke with the spirits. I don't know who I spoke with, but they came through and they're like, this is what it is.
It was MK.
When I saw you introduced on the premiere episode, I thought, this is brilliant. This lady's going to cause some ripples within the hotel. And throughout the show, people really did question your abilities, didn't they? But you proved, as you left the show, you're pretty much bang on. Yeah. What do you say to people who are sceptical?
This is an interesting question. I 100% respect everyone's worldviews and beliefs. Usually, though, when a sceptic does come to me, they walk away believing. And there's also a lot of, like, scientific evidence and proof that this phenomena is true. You just have to have a little Google. It's all there.
When did you realise that you had these special abilities?
Yeah, so I was 23, got heavily into meditation, came out of a year-long meditation, and I was like, oh, my gosh, I can speak with the spirits.
Wow.
Yeah. I love it. I love it, and I want to see it.
We would love to see you in action, actually. So
we're
going to bring in one of our gorgeous girls from The Office, Rowena. She's one of our production staff. Hello, lovely.
Hi.
Thought we could do a reading on Rowena.
Yeah.
Live, yeah.
Let's do it.
And you don't know each other, obviously.
No, we don't. Okay.
Get it on.
So I'm just going to connect my energy to you, and we'll see who will come in. Okay, beautiful. Here we go. So I have an older female coming through, definitely a grandmother figure. She actually has similar hair colour to yours. It's a little bit lighter. And she's sitting down in a kitchen. There's a kitchen table there with her as well. And she's just knitting. Okay, let's see what she wants to share. Okay, so she's referencing the name Maria. So do you know who Maria is?
Yeah, it's my mum.
That's your mum. Okay, let's see what she's saying. Now, she's telling me that your mum, that there's a gold bracelet of hers. So there's some jewellery that your grandma's passed on.
I think so.
So you have to, ask her about the bracelet and then a gold ring with a diamond as well. But your mum is keeping it in her top drawer. It's a reference to being in the drawer. Has your mum had some heart issues? Do you know of the chest?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, my God, that's so scary.
And is this in the past year?
Yeah, she's had some health issues.
Yeah, okay. What they're saying to her is, this is going to be quite a little bit intense, but there is actually some tissue on her right breast at the top that she does need to get checked. And it's talking about her cholesterol. She's saying that everything's fine, but it's very important for her to get that checked. Now, she's also talking about you having a child. So is that something you've been thinking about?
I've been on the fence about it, but I'm 30 years old, so I've got time.
Oh, you've got plenty of time. Let's see if there's some spirits up there. Okay. She's saying two children. There is a dark-haired male that's coming through that you will have these two children with. Are you currently living with a dark-haired male?
Yes.
That's your partner?
Yes.
Yeah, so you're going to have children with him. There's two. We've got...
He's going to freak out.
What's his name, Rowena?
James.
Hi, James.
Uncle Paul.
A boy and a girl and a beautiful wedding. I don't know if you're already engaged.
No.
Oh, you're not. Oh, sorry. Yeah, so you got him. It's beautiful.
Okay. Cool.
Lots of
so
things
he's definitely in my future?
Yeah, 100%.
Cool.
Yeah, beautiful. It was lovely.
Are you
to
okay, Rowena?
You
look a little bit shaky.
It's a lot of information, like, especially with my mum. Like, she has been going through some health issues, so I'll definitely ask her to get that checked. But yeah, like, Maria is her name, and her mum's name's actually Maria. So my grandma's named Maria Jose.
No wonder she said the name as well. Yeah. So she's sharing that too.
Oh, wow.
That's beautiful.
Whoa, Chloe. Wow.
Creepy.
Yeah, Chloe, right? This has been full on.
Yeah.
So intense. But we're excited because we've got some babies to celebrate and a wedding.
If you know where Rowena's mum lives as well, it's in the top shelf, everyone.
Don't miss The Traitors. Sunday to Tuesday night, 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Chloe, thank you so much for chatting with us this morning and giving us a reading. And
thanks, Rowena, for giving it a go.
You're fun to watch on the show. Well done.
A lot to take in.
Good on you. See? So now we know who the traitors are.